Hi guys, CodeTutor here and my name is Anil Deshpande.
In this video, we will talk about an important feature of Kotlin called as null safety. Well, coming from Java or for that matter any programming language, null pointer exceptions are very common. That is basically when you forget to initialize object and then if you use that particular object somewhere in your application, you are definitely bound to get a null pointer exception. So putting a null check, that is if something is not equal to null and then proceeding to going to do something, is a very common practice in most of the programming languages, and Java is no exception to that. Well, Kotlin tries to solve this particular problem by providing an inherent null safety feature built into the way you write your program. Now, what do I mean by this? So let me declare a variable here. Let me make it of type int and initialize it to 10. Now let me initialize sample variable is equal to null. You can see that as soon as I write this, I get a compile time error that null cannot be a value to a non-null type int. So basically what compiler is trying to complain about is this particular sample variable is of not nullable type. Now how to fix this? Well, all you have to do is put a question mark in front of the data type that you have already declared, and now that particular variable becomes nullable type. And with this, you can now assign null value to a variable. Just to demonstrate the fact, I can write a simple if null check, that is if sample variable is not equal to null, then I can say print we have a value, and I can print the value here. Else I can just print we don't have the value. And now if I try to run this, you can see that we are getting into else part because it is initialized as null. And now just before the if statement, if I once again initialize sample variable to something and run the application, once again you will get into a positive use case. Well, there are some interesting advantages of having this particular null safety built into a programming language. For example, I can declare another variable. Let me call it as say sample string, which is of type string, make it nullable type, and I will give some random string content to that. And now I want to know what is the length of this particular sample string. So what I can do is I can declare a val string length and sample string length dot length. Right now it is giving me a compile time error. So since it is nullable type, you cannot invoke directly function on the nullable object. You have to use the save operator. That is, you have to use the question mark in front of the variable so that you can safely invoke length. Now let me print this. The string length is, you can now see that this string length is 16. Let's assume that I had initialized the sample string to null, and now see what happens. You can observe that we did not get a null pointer exception, but rather we got a value as null. If some of you are really interested in experiencing null pointer exception, then you can use this double exclamation mark, which is called as not-null assertion. And now if you do this, now you will observe that you will get a null pointer exception. There is another operator which can be used with null safety, that is called as Elvis operator. How the Elvis operator looks? It looks like a question mark and colon. This is not unique to Kotlin. You will find it even other programming language like Swift, for example. So the advantage of using Elvis operator is it is basically like telling if this particular variable is not null, then use it. Otherwise, use the other option. Well, what do I mean by that is sample string question mark length. If this is not null, then use this particular option to initialize the string length. Otherwise, you can initialize it to unknown length. And now what happens is when I run this particular application, you will see that the string length is unknown. And if I comment out this particular line, and if I once again run this particular code, now you will see that the string length is 16. Just to once again clarify, Elvis operator is basically used with null safety. So what you write on the left hand side is what should happen when the variable is not null, that is properly initialized. And what you write on the right hand side is what should happen if the variable is null. Another way you can use null safety is when you do typecasting. So what do I mean by that is I can use sample variable and use sample string as int, and if I run this, it will give me typecast exception. But however, if I use safecast, you don't see any typecast exception. And let me print the value of sample variable here. It will print that as null. So this is how you can use safe casting when you do type casting. So that's it about null safety in Kotlin. We will continue to explore Kotlin in the upcoming videos. Stay tuned.
That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.